Hello, my name's Joe Carini. Welcome to Bristol. It's a beautiful city. Bristol used to be a famous port. The port has now closed, but there are beautiful office places and places where people live and work. The university is the largest employer in the city, has about 5,500 employees and about 18,500 students. The reason why we're here is to talk about the ice pig. The ice pig was invented or developed here, and the genesis for ice pigging was a way of cleaning out not pipelines for the water industry, but bits of kit and equipment for food manufacturers. The genesis of ice pigging was, wouldn't it be great if we could push something through that would actually remove the material and product recover? The thing that was going to product recover should be such that there is no impact on safety, and we came up with the ice pig. The ice pig consists of crystals of ice, and in between the matrix of crystals is water. The amount of water to the amount of ice is computed, or at least an estimate is made, by pressing, by filtering out the water in a cafetiere test, and we're going to squeeze it. And it doesn't really matter how hard we squeeze, we'll always get the same result if the ice fraction's the same. What's really happening is that the solid is being squeezed at the bottom, and now the ice particles are acting as a hard solid. That really is a semi-solid. So when left to its own devices, it can actually hold a structure. If that were a liquid, it would have flown away. This isn't, this is a solid. But yet, when squeezed, it will flow like a liquid, pushing away and cleaning the surface beneath it. The amount of water that's actually going through after it's been through the system is this amount, so it gives you an idea of what the flow rates are. Not very much, but not unrepresentative. What will happen now is that we'll switch from water to the ice pig, the ice slurry, at roughly the same speed, the same flow rate, the same volume flow rate. Ice will come down here and start filling, and you can actually see the slurry now. This is very weak slurry, but it's getting thicker and stronger. The ice is going down. That slurry is unable to move the sand, so it's still a slushy pig. It's now getting thicker and thicker and thicker and thicker, and there it goes. Great big dollops of sand being moved by the pig, leaving behind clean surface. So, at the moment, there's sand here being carried by the pig. And the really interesting thing is that the sand is being denser, is on the bottom. As it goes over, it wants to be on the top, but gravity's taking it down. You can see it rotating, beautiful, dropping back down to the bottom. Remember, flow rate the same as the water flush, and here's the sand all being taken out. Not being pushed through, bulldozed, but slowly taken out. So no possibility of any sand getting stuck. It's just transported away happily. I'm very pleased that the ice pigging technology is being tested in the Netherlands by two major water companies, Oasen and Wittens.
We zijn hier op dit moment op de demolocatie in Alphen aan den Rijn. Wat we gaan doen in eerste instantie is een stukje uit de leiding nemen om te kijken wat onze uitgangssituatie is, waarmee we dus vaststellen van hoe vervuild de leiding op deze moment is. Daarna gaan we het stukje opnieuw herstellen en gaan we de leiding nogmaals doorspoelen op de conventionele techniek. Als we dat gedaan hebben, dan gaan we de leidingdeel vervangen door een stuk transparante buis en dan gaan we het vervolgens schoonmaken met de ijsproptechniek. Met deze nieuwe techniek gaan we eens kijken of dat een betere schoonmaakmethode is dan dat we tot nu toe altijd gedaan hebben in de drinkwaterwereld.
I'm even more pleased that the tests have proven to be so successful. Oasen and Wittens have demonstrated in the field that ice pigging can be used in very difficult circumstances. It is able to clean pipes that would previously been impossible to do, or the costs of doing so would have been prohibitive. I'm delighted at the experience that we've all gained from these trials. I'm also very pleased that you've visited Bristol. Thank you.